Now I'm sure.
Let's wait for.
Okay, let's wait for two more minutes and then we'll start with the. Acha, now tell me, question answers of chapter 8 and 9 both are complete?
Yes, ma'am.
Right.
Yes, ma'am.
I think we started with that chapter, no? Civics chapter 6.
Ma'am, civics chapter 6.
Yes,
Tanisha. Yes, ma'am, civics chapter 6.
We'll continue with the same. So, till that time, I'll take the attendance, right?
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning,
Vita. Okay.
Daksh, good morning.
Ma'am, today what we will do?
Beta, we'll continue with the same chapter, no? Chapter 6 of civics we were doing. So we'll continue with that, right?
Ma'am, syllabus, ma'am, 8 and 9 chapter are coming.
No. So what is the date today?
Ma'am,
28th.
Very good. Your attendance now. We have Daksh in the class.
Then, present, ma'am.
Okay, fine. Then we have Ilma. Ilma, are you there? Ilma, are you there?
Yes, ma'am.
Kushagra Singh.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, Kumar Parth. Sorry, Kumar Parth.
Yes, ma'am.
Then we have Anushka Gupta. Is there in the class?
No, ma'am. She is not there.
But it is showing, her name is showing Anushka Gupta.
Ma'am, she is not connected with
audio. Ma'am, she has not connected her audio.
Okay, that is why she did not respond. Fine. Then we have Kushal, Shreyansh Kumar Singh.
I'm present.
Okay. Then we have Siddhi.
Listen, ma'am.
Siddhi Mittal. Okay. Then Tanishka, we have Vanshraj Gill.
Present, ma'am.
Then we have Yash Raj Raghuvanshi. No, Vanshika is also there. And then yes, Yash Raj Raghuvanshi. Fine. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11. Fine. Only I think 11 participants are there. Right,
ma'am, we have to give online exams online, ma'am, final exams online.
Beta, nothing has been decided yet. You will be informed, don't worry. Okay,
okay,
chapter 6, right. Those who were there in the previous class when we started with this chapter, can anybody give me a recapitulation what we have done till where we have completed? Anybody who can give me a short recapitulation?
Ma'am, we have done the story part that is given on the page 2.
Yes.
279 and 280. That ma'am, we have done. And ma'am, you have also asked what is difference between court and police.
Okay, what else?
Ma'am, till here we have done.
Okay, fine. Now let us start one more. Like, see this comic clipping that was given over here. They have simply, you know, they have told you that how, you know, a car met with an accident. reporting was done to the police, and immediately police reaches the, you know, the accident area, and then the people, those who were there in that accident involved, they were taken to the hospital, and from the hospital they were brought to the police station, and then a charge sheet was prepared against Myra because she was driving the car. And Myra, like, after the court proceedings, prosecution, then this defense lawyers and prosecution lawyers both were there to, you know, defend their clients. And then after that, all the hearing and after all the proceedings of the court, it was decided that Myra was guilty, and she had to pay 5 lakhs to the family of the boys who died in the accident. And moreover, she had to, to be in the prison for, she was imprisoned for 3 years. Right? This much is clear to all of you?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, yes,
fine.
Ma'am.
Fine. Now, tell me from these two, you know, from this comic strip, what have you understood about the police and about the court?
Ma'am, we understand that a police has to done the investigation about the things happened, like, ma'am, anything, ma'am, like the accident which happened and the two people died, and then they have registered ma'am, FIR, ma'am. Then they got to know that Myra is driving, and she don't know driving, but little bit she know, and by her bad driving, two people were died. Then the court has to take the reaction, or ma'am, they had to take the they had to take the case about Myra and two people died.
Listen, Parth. What I'm asking is, what was the role of police and what was the role of court in this case?
Ma'am, role of court is to give the judgment about the thing happened by the whole evidence against or in the for of case, like Myra is not good driver, but still she is driving. So that's why two people died. And for police, they had to investigate the case, what all the things happened, why two people died, like this.
Okay. See, in anybody in the class who would like to tell? Tanishka?
Yes, ma'am.
Tell. What was the role of police and court in this case? They had similar role, or the roles were different? Tell.
Ma'am, somewhere the role is different, because the police only decide that the case which has come in the police station is big or small, it needs to go to the court or not. So I think so, it's their role is different.
See, very good, Tanishka. See, both the court and the police has different roles to play. See, whenever a culprit is caught, whenever an offense takes place, okay? When this offense takes place, it is the moral responsibility of the police to catch hold of the person who is responsible for that offense, right? But police has no authority to punish the person who has committed a crime. Their only job is to get that person arrested. The decision of whether the punishment should be given or not, and if yes, what type of punishment should be given, this is completely the jurisdiction of the court, right? Police has no authority to punish anybody. Got my point, class?
Yes, ma'am.
Fine. Now, second thing comes. Now, if police has no authority to punish, then why they are given the responsibility of catching, they have given the responsibility of arresting? See, it is because we all know that law and order is maintained by the police, right? And the courts are there to help the police. Now, how do these courts, they help the police in, you know, ensuring law and order, or how do they, like, how do they punish? Because see, we all know that judiciary follows all the laws that are written in the constitution, right? Right, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Fine. Now, whenever anybody violates these laws, then there are, if you remember, in class 7th or in class 8th only, I have told you about the articles and the schedules and the sections.
Yes, ma'am.
That are there in the constitution, right? So under the described articles, sections, the laws that are there, violation of every law has a punishment, right? Like it is written over here that Myra was charged under IPC section 337 and 304. So these charges that are there, these people, the court ensures that whatever charges have been put by the police, are they correct or not? Is the person really guilty or not? Has the person really committed the crime or not? Now, this is done in the court by the lawyers. The lawyers are there for defense and for the prosecution, right? These people, they defend their clients. They do questioning and answering in the court, and the court proceeding goes on. Now, there are certain norms. There are certain conditions that if a person is, arrested by the police, when that person is to be presented before the magistrate, before taking that person to the court, after arrest, when the person is arrested, when the police has to take that person to the court, and who is going to prepare the charge sheet, and how the proceedings how the further proceedings will take place, all these things are there written under the laws, right? Nobody does anything that is not prescribed or given in the constitution. So we all are following the same laws, right? Now, after the court proceedings are done, it is decided by the court only, by the judge, that whether the person is, like, whatever evidences are, given, the witnesses are brought to the, courts. From there, questioning and answering session takes place. Then defense lawyer asks questions. Then prosecution also asks the questions. After questioning and answering, ultimately, if it is proved that the person who was brought to the, court, by the police is guilty, then the judge decides the punishment, right? Whatever charges have been put against that person, the judge, goes through that and decides what kind of punishment should be given. So the role of police is completely different and role of courts are completely different, right? Right, class?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So in this case, both the police and the courts have played their own individual roles in deciding whether Myra was guilty or not. Am I clear, class?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Fine. Now let us read courts and police, right? Tanishka, can you read it for me, beta?
Ma'am, what?
Can you read page 281, courts and police? If you have.
Okay, ma'am.
No.
Courts and police. The courts have played a very significant and productive role in laying the foundations of constitutional law. Although the Indian Parliament...
Significant.
The court have played a very significant and productive role in laying the foundation of...
Beta, Tanishka, it is significant, not significant, okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Significant, okay?
The court have played a very significant and productive role in laying the foundation of constitutional law, although the Indian Parliament decides what the laws will be. The courts decide how these laws will be applied to particular cases. The courts play an important role in delivering justice to the people. They are the protectors of the fundamental rights of the people and are known for their impartial decisions in all disputes. The police, on the other hand, are responsible for maintaining law and order in the state. Whenever a crime is committed, the police arrest the suspect based on the FIR, first information report. filled with them. They investigate a crime by identifying the witnesses, recording their statements and producing them in the court when required. It is also their task to gather all evidences related to the crime and to present a charges sheet in the court against an accused. However, the police cannot punish the criminals. They present the accused to the court. It is the task of the court to decide whether the suspect is actually the person who had committed crime or not. If the suspect is found guilty, he is given a suitable punishment by the court. However, during the period of trial, the suspect remains in the custody of the police.
Fine. I hope many things are clear now from here.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now see, charge sheet is always prepared after the person is brought to the police station, and whosoever is the in charge person goes and finds out that whether the person who was charged is actually the one who has committed the crime or not. Because police works on the FIR, first information report that the police receives, right, by any person through telephonic call in a written form or verbally, right? Anything that comes to police in the form of FIR, first information report, whether oral, whether through phone or in written, that has to be considered as the first information report FIR. Then only the action is taken. And after that, the charge sheet is prepared. Right, class?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Right. Anything that I need to explain in this particular topic, courts and police?
No, ma'am.
No.
Yes, Park wants to ask something. Park, you want to ask something? ओके नाउ प्रिवेंशन अगेंस्ट आर्बिट्रेरी अरेस्ट एंड डिटेंशन. बेटा कई बार क्या होता है, एट टाइम्स इट हैपेंस कि जो है जैसे अभी जब हम लोग व्हेन वी विल रीड अबाउट द इंडियन नेशनल मूवमेंट, वी विल आल्सो रीड अबाउट यू नो जस्ट अ मोमेंट वी विल आल्सो रीड अबाउट दैट हाउ यू नो द ब्रिटिश they tried to bring a rule in the country when they were ruling, the Rowlatt Act, which stated that any political prisoner could be put behind the bars for indefinite time period, right? So these kind of laws, they are considered as arbitrary laws, where you know where the person like in that Rowlatt Act, what was given? It was given that the British government will have complete control over the arrest of the person, and without taking to the court, without trial, they can be put into jail for any time period. Right? So this is something which was not acceptable by the Indians. So they, they demonstrated, they agitated against this law. They never wanted that the British government should bring this law. Same way, if a person is arrested by the police, there are certain conditions that are to be fulfilled by the police. Police cannot put that person, directly into the jail without presenting that person to the magistrate. Without a trial, that person cannot be, put into jails. A charge sheet has to be prepared, and within 24 hours of arrest of that person, he needs to be presented before the magistrate in the court. Right? Before, without doing these two things, that person could not be put into the jail for a long period of time. I hope I am clear and understood over here.
Yes, ma'am.
Fine. Now, Parth, who is there? Shreyansh, are you there?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, Shreyansh, read this prevention against arbitrary arrest and detention.
Prevention against arbitrary arrest and detention. In carrying out its investigation, the police may arrest and interrogate people to ensure that the police investigation falls in the gambit of ethics and human rights. The Supreme Court has clearly laid down some guidelines to be followed by the police and other investigating agencies in the arrest, detention, and interrogation of any person. These are known as the D.K. Basu guidelines. Besides these guidelines, Article 22 of our Constitution also provides safeguards against arbitrary arrest and detention. The rights of arrested person under this right include the right to be informed of the grounds of arrest at the time of arrest, the right to consult and be defended by a legal practitioner of choice, the right to be produced before the nearest magistrate within a period of 24 hours of arrest. D.K. Basu guidelines. Some of the provisions under the guidelines include these. At the time of arrest, the police must prepare a memo of the date, time, and venue of arrest. The memo has to be countersigned by the arrested person as well as by at least one witness. The investigating agency police must wear clear, visible, and identifiable name tags along with their designation at the time of
making designation
at the time of making an arrest. The arrested detained person has the right to inform a relative or friend. If the friend or relative does not live with excuse, the police must inform them within 8 to 12 hours of the arrest. The rights of the arrested detained person should be made known to him at the time of arrest. The right not to be tortured or ill-treated at any point of time by the investigating agencies. Confessions made in police custody cannot be deemed as evidence since it may involve coercion or torture. Police official at the district level.
Wait. Yes, class. Do I need to explain anything over here or is it all clear and understood to you people?
Ma'am, clear.
Very good. Okay, now coming to the next part, that is police officials at the district level. See, if you all have the books with you, on page number 282, on right hand side of the page, you have got, you know, something written in blue lines. A flowchart is given over there, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Here they have given, you know, as per the designation, they have given the names. Like who is at the top, like who holds the highest position in the police, and who holds the lowest position, like, you know, as per the cadre or the ranks. Like there they have given, chowkidar is at the lowest in the hierarchy, then police constable, then we have head constable, then we have assistant sub-inspector police, then we have sub-inspector police, SI, jisko hum bolte hain, then we have inspector of police, that is inspector, jisko hum inspector hi bulate hain, then we have ASP or DSP, assistant superintendent of police or deputy superintendent of police. Then we have additional superintendent of police, and on the top we have the superintendent of police, jisko hum SP bulate hain. Theek hai? These are the designations. Okay, beta?
Yes, ma'am.
Aap mein se kisi ke father police mein hai?
Yes, ma'am. Mine.
Shreyansh ke papa hai?
Yes, ma'am.
ठीक है, तो आपको पता होंगे डेजिग्नेशन सारे के सारे, है ना?
Yes, ma'am.
चलिए ठीक है, that's so good. चलिए, so in this police officials at the district level पे कौन कौन से पुलिस वाले होते हैं, कौन हाईएस्ट उस पे होता है, कौन लोएस्ट उस पे होता है, वो सारे के सारे डिटेल्स आर गिवन ओवर हियर, राइट क्लास?
यस ma'am.
एंड what are the workings of these people at district level, that is also given over here. So I would like Kushagra Singh to read out if he is there in the class.
मैम आई एम ईटिंग ब्रेकफास्ट.
बहुत ट्राई लगाएंगे, गलत बात है, दिस इज नॉट डन. सो फॉर जस्ट टू टू थ्री मूवमेंट मिनट्स यू कीप योर ब्रेकफास्ट असाइड एंड रीड फॉर मी. और शैल आई टेल समबडी एल्स टू रीड?
मैम कैन आई? मैम मैम.
ओके दक्ष, ओके कुशाग्र, यू कैरी ऑन विद योर ब्रेकफास्ट बेटा, कैरी ऑन विद योर ब्रेकफास्ट. चलो दक्ष रीड.
मैम फ्रॉम पुलिस ऑफिशियल्स एट द डिस्ट्रिक्ट लेवल.
यस बच्चा, फ्रॉम हियर.
मैम, a state is divided into several districts. For the convenience of administration, the district collector looks after the administration of the district. To maintain law and order in the district, several police officials are appointed. The highest police official in a district in the district is, ma'am, what is it written?
District is the superintendent of police.
Okay, ma'am. Superintendent of the police, who is answerable to the district collector. He is assigned by the other police officers.
Assisted by.
Okay, ma'am. Okay, ma'am. Assisted by the other police officer in maintaining law and order in the district. Below the superintendent of police is the deputy superintendent of police. Under him are the inspectors, sub inspectors. Assistant, sub inspector, head constable, constable, and chowkidar. Ma'am, then this table.
Table I have already read for you. So you carry on with the next paragraph.
Okay. Each deputy superintendent of police heads the various subdivisions of a district. There may be five or more such divisions. The inspector of police services about 10 police stations. Each police station has sub-inspector, assistant sub-inspectors, head constable and constable. In the villages, chowkidars are appointed who help the police in arresting the culprits. As we learned earlier, whenever an offense is committed, the police come into the pictures as the investigating agency. Once the court punish an accused thing move within the purview of the police again, the accused now come to serve their term in the prison. Each district has a jail which is supervised by a jailer who looks after the functioning of the jail. Efforts are made to mend the ways of the criminals. They are taught different skills like basket weaving and carpentry.
Okay, very good. Now tell me, this is all clear and understood to you all?
Yes, yes ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
A quick rapid fire, right? All those who are there in the class, just to make you, you know, remember that who heads where, right? Like, tell me, question number one. Who heads the subdivisions of a district? Who heads the subdivisions of a district?
Deputy Superintendent of Police.
Very good, Parth. Very good. How many divisions are there?
Ma'am, there are five.
There are five or more subdivisions. Very good. How many police stations are supervised by a
Ten police stations.
Very good. Ten police stations. Very good, class. Very good. Now tell me. In every police station, who are there appointed?
Ma'am, sub-inspector, assistant, sub-inspector, head constable,
Parth, Bhavya ko batane do beta. Bhavya ko batane do, Parth.
Okay, ma'am.
Haan, Bhavya batao bachi.
Ma'am, sub-inspectors, assistant, sub-inspectors, head constables, and constables.
Very good. Fine. Very good. Now tell me, who helps the police in arresting the culprits in the villages? Who helps?
Chowkidar.
Chowkidar.
Very good. Chowkidars in the village help the police in arresting the culprits. Very good. Now tell me, in the hierarchy of the police officials at the district level, who is on the top?
Ma'am, can you repeat the question?
My question is, in the hierarchy of the police officials at the district level, who tops the hierarchy?
Superintendent of police.
Yes, superintendent of police. Very good, very good. Now tell me, at which level, at which number the police constable comes?
Ma'am, police constable second. Ma'am, from top or ma'am from lower?
From top.
Ma'am, from top.
Ma'am, seventh.
Ma'am, ninth.
Eighth number.
Very
good. Sorry, ma'am.
Eighth.
No issues at all. Now, tell me, what is the number of inspector of police in the hierarchy?
Ma'am, fourth.
Fourth.
Inspector of police.
Very good.
And fourth.
And police head constable comes at which number?
Ma'am, a seventh.
Seventh. Very good. What is the full form of ASP and DSP? Wait. Vanshraj, are you there? Vansh, are you there? Siddhi, are you there?
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, the full form is assistant. The full form is assistant deputy superintendent of police.
नहीं, हमने पूछा ASP और DSP को आपको अलग-अलग बताना है.
Ma'am, can I tell?
Yeah, ma'am.
Let's ASP. हाँ, बताओ Siddhi.
Ma'am, ASP full form is assistant superintendent of police. Yes. And DSP full form is Deputy Superintendent of Police.
Very good. Very good. Then what is the full form of additional SP? Bhavya?
Additional.
Shreyansh.
Additional Superintendent of Police.
Very good. Very good. चलिए. I hope इतना अच्छे से learn हो गया आपको याद हो जाएगा अभी है ना?
Yes, ma'am.
अच्छा एक लास्ट चीज बताओ, हु इज द हाईएस्ट पुलिस ऑफिशियल इन अ डिस्ट्रिक्ट?
मैम, सुपरिंटेंडेंट ऑफ
पुलिस.
एंड
एमएसपी सुपरिंटेंडेंट ऑफ पुलिस.
वेरी गुड. दिस सुपरिंटेंडेंट ऑफ पुलिस इज आंसरेबल टू हूम इन द डिस्ट्रिक्ट? ही इज आंसरेबल टू हूम इन द डिस्ट्रिक्ट?
मैम, टू द
district collector.
Yes, DC, district collector. Very good. Very good. चलिए शाबाश. इतना समझ में आ गया सबको? इसमें कोई ऐसी चीज that you are not able to understand?
No, ma'am.
Very good. Very good. अब ठीक है. अब जो next topics that we are going to read, it is about first information report, that is FIR that I talked about. Then who can lodge this FIR? Is there any criteria that only specific, citizens of the country can only lodge the FIR, or anybody who, witnesses an offense taking place can go and give the FIR? Then what is the procedure of filing an FIR? Then what should be mentioned in the FIR? What should be done if the FIR is not registered? Then, after this FIR part, how to launch, when to launch, why to launch, then what are the norms for it? All these things we are going to read in the next topics that are there on page number 283, right? So who will read it for me?
Ma'am, may I?
Okay, Bhavya, very good. Read up.
Ma'am, can I?
Chalo, let Bhavya read, okay, Daksh?
Okay, ma'am.
Padho, beta.
Ma'am, first information report, FIR. The report pertaining the occurrence of cognizable offense received at the police station is called the first information report, popularly known as FIR. Since it is the first information about an offense, so it is called. On receipt of this information, the police registered the report in an FIR register and begins the investigation of the crime.
Okay.
Any person who knows about an offense or crime may give information to the police in the form of a complaint. Okay. This complaint can be given either orally or in written.
Okay.
If it is an oral compliment, the officer in charge of the police station will convert it into a written one. This complaint is converted into an FIR by filling of information into a form of the station house officer, SHO. The FIR should be lodged in the police station of the concerned area where the crime has taken place. Who can launch an FIR? Anyone who knows about or has seen the occurrence of cognizable offense can be file an FIR. It is not necessary that only the victims of the crime should file an FIR. A police officer who comes to know about the cognizable offense can also file an FIR. After the registration of the FIR, investigation of the police begins.
Okay, very good. Read the box as well.
Okay, ma'am. Procedure of filling an FIR. The procedure of filling an FIR is as described here. When information of the commission of a cognizable offense is given orally, the police must write it down. Second, as a person giving the information or making a complaint, one can demand that the information recorded by the police is read out after being written down. Third, once the information has been recorded by the police, it must be